thoracic cage and abdominal cavity. Okay. And diaphragm consists of muscle. Look here. This peripheral part of diaphragm, it is muscle. And name of this muscle, musculus phrenicus. And muscle continue into tendon. And in central part, tendon of this muscle formed centrum tendinum. Centrum tendinum. In this center, we can see opening where inferior vena cava pass. And muscle of diaphragm starts from different bone. Itis posteriorly, it starts from lumbar vertebrae. Then laterally, it starts from ribs. And in front, it starts from the sternum. I draw a small diagram here. It is sternum. And muscle, part of this muscle starts from sternum. It is pars sternalis. Next, it is pars costalis. It starts from ribs. Here, pars costalis. It starts from ribs. And it is vertebra. And pars lumbalis starts from lumbar vertebra. And again, pars costalis, pars sternalis, pars costalis, and pars lumbalis. Between these three parts, we can see triangles. It is one triangle, and the same opposite. What is the name? It is pars sternalis and pars costalis. What is the name of this triangle? Trigonum sterna costalis. It is triangle between pars lumbalis and pars costalis. What is the name of this triangle? Lumbar costalis. Four triangles, two of them trigonum lumbar costalis and two triangles trigonum sterna costalis. In these triangles, absent muscle of diaphragm. What present it is? Diaphragm, it is. It is muscle of diaphragm. And superiorly, muscle of diaphragm has fascia, fascia and thoracica, and above of fascia, pleura. Below of muscle, it is fascia subperitonealis and peritoneum. And if in triangles, absent muscle of diaphragm, what present it is? Only two fascia, and the thoracic and subperitonealis, pleura and peritoneum, without muscles. Clear? That is why triangles are weak places of diaphragm, and it is maybe diaphragmatic hernia. Clear? And last moment, pars lumbalis consists of two branches, two crus, crus mediale and crus laterale. They join together and formed opening, and through this opening aorta pass. Look here, it is pars lumbalis, is joined together and formed hiatus aorticus. Aorta pass through diaphragm in this hiatus. Then these two parts divides and join together one again and surround another opening, hiatus esophagus. Esophagus pass through diaphragm in this hiatus. Two hiatus, aorticus, hiatus esophagus, and one opening in centrum tendinum, foramen vena cava. That is diaphragm. Next, muscles of the chest. Let's go. Muscles of the chest. Superficial muscles are musculus pectoralis major and musculus pectoralis minor. Major muscle, it has three parts. First part starts from clavicle, and name of this part, pars clavicularis. Another part starts from the sternum and ribs. It is pars sternocostalis. And last part start from vagina of musculus rectus abdominis. That is why it is pars abdominalis, pars clavicularis, pars sternocostalis, and pars abdominalis together formed musculus pectoralis major, and this muscle attached to crista tuberculi majoris. Function, its clavicular part take place in flexion of the arm and hold this muscle, perform adduction and pronation. If we fixed our hands, it take place in inspiration. Musculus pectoralis minor start from the ribs, from second till fifth ribs, and attached to coracoid process. Function, its move shoulder girdle forward and downward, and if we fixed our hands, its pull ribs upward in time of inspiration. Next muscle, it is musculus serratus anterior. Today you know two posterior muscles. Please favor, where musculus serratus posterior superior? Oh, superior. No? Yes, it is superior and inferior serratus muscle. And now it is serratus, musculus serratus anterior. It starts from 9 upper ribs and attached to middle body of the clavicle, of the scapula. Function, it's rotate scapula in time when we abduct our hand above of horizontal level, together with musculus trapezius. Deep muscles of the chest, and they are autochthonous muscles of the chest, are musculi intercostalis externi, musculi intercostalis interni. These muscles occupy space between ribs, and differences between these muscles in direction. They have opposite direction. For example, external muscles start from lower body of upper rib and attach to upper body of the lower rib and pass from to forward. They pass forward, downward and forward. Internal muscles, musculi intercostalis interni, start from upper body of the lower rib and go upward and forward to lower body of the upper rib. Between cartilages of the ribs, absent external muscles. Continuation of external muscles here is membrane, membrana intercostalis externa. And deep muscles are absent between angle of the rib to vertebral column. Here it is. Look here, this white tissue, it is membrane, and name of this membrane, membrana intercostalis interna. Another muscles, they are absent on these diagrams, that is musculi subcostalis. They have direction like musculi intercostalis interni, but they overlap through one or two ribs. And they have the same function like musculi intercostalis interni. And last muscle is also absent on these diagrams. It is musculus transversus thoracis. It starts from sternum and go to lower ribs. 7th, 8th, 9th, 6th, 5th ribs. It's pull ribs downward in time of inspiration. Fascia of the chest. Musculus pectoralis major superficially has fascia lamina superficialis of fascia pectoralis. And musculus pectoralis minor supply with the help of deep layer lamina profunda of fascia pectoralis. These two lamina, superficial and deep, fused together in two places. First place, it is sulcus deltoidea pectoralis. Here it is, superficial and deep fascia fused together. And last part, last place where superficial and deep fascia fuse together, that is lower border of musculus pectoralis major. Here it is, they fused and continue into fascia axillaris. And from sulcus deltoidei pectoralis, fascia pectoralis continue to deltoid muscle like fascia deltoidea. And last fascia, fascia endothoracica, it is inside of thoracic cage, supply ribs and internal muscles of the chest, and superiorly supply diaphragm, fascia endothoracica. It is all muscles and fascia of the chest and diaphragm.
Thank you.